chocolate fun fest and festival today. Look at all what we've got here. There's white chocolate in two forms, and cocoa, and bittersweet, and bitter, and Marcel de Saunier is going to lead us through this great event.
Well, I hope so. I love chocolate, and if you catch me putting my finger in the chocolate bowl and licking it, you'll get my point here. And we do have quite an array, and we're going to be melting some white chocolate for the patty cake, mm-hmm. and then some dark chocolate for some chocolate balloons that we're going to be doing a little later on. So if we want to get right into that, I'll chop the white chocolate.
Tell me a little more about the white chocolate. There's some that's not very good, and there's some that's better.
That's right. You've got to check out the label, and when you do that, look for cocoa butter. Need to have cocoa butter, and when you say, well, doesn't it all have cocoa butter?
No.
In fact, it doesn't. A lot of this stuff is called white coating. It can't even be called white chocolate.
Oh.
So I'm chopping this into about a quarter of an inch.
Probably.
And if you'd like to, we can start melting the dark chocolate. And we're using a couple of double boilers. So, Julie, if you'd like to put the... we'll put that right on this one here. So we've got a bowl with the chocolate on top and then about an inch of water in the bottom
there. And the water's not touching the bowl.
It's not. And it's going to take 2 or 3 minutes. So while I'm chopping the white chocolate here, that'll get going. So I'm going to start melting the white chocolate now. I'll take the top portion of what we call an official double boiler and put my white chocolate in here.
How much you got there?
And I've got 12 ounces of white chocolate, and then we're going to put a couple of tablespoons of water. The white chocolate has a lot of cocoa butter in it. All chocolate has cocoa butter.
No.
Because that is the fat in the chocolate, we have to handle this a little differently. And in fact, we're adding more fat to this because we're doing some unsalted butter. We've got 4 tablespoons of unsalted butter. And I use a whisk with the white chocolate because it needs to come together as an emulsion. And in order to do that, we really have to move with it. And if you don't mind, we could stir this up a little bit more, because if you do that, you'll notice probably in about the time that I've got the white chocolate completely melted here, that will be as well. And that's good semi-sweet chocolate there. And let's look at our dark chocolate here. And that actually, we can shut off the heat on this one, if you would. The dark chocolate, we're going to be dipping some balloons in here a little bit later on. Having some fun. That's right. We'll have some fun with that. I just hope I can blow those balloons
odd.
Up. So see how nice and smooth
that
is.
Lovely.
Yeah. So let's see what happens here. And you can see how that looks a little bit as if it's separating, but with some vigorous whisking. But it definitely has a different viscosity, as you can see.
Definitely.
Than the,
I didn't realize it was as fussy.
Yeah, but here, see how it's getting smooth now?
Yeah. You know.
So I think we can actually leave it right there, and we'll shut the
heat off. Okay, there.
Yeah, and when in doubt, when working with chocolate, as far as the amount of heat that we're using, is just shut the heat off.
Yeah.
Because we can always bring it back.
Mm-hmm.
So if this, for instance, now, the optimum temperature for this after melting is about 125 degrees.
Mm-hmm.
And then if we try to put the balloons in here at that temperature, though, there's a chance we might get a little explosion going on. So we want to cool it down to about 90 degrees.
Yeah.
And that's not only because we don't want to burst anybody's bubble. It's because we actually are doing something very similar to tempering chocolate. That is rehardening it so that it has that little bit of snap. So 90 degrees is just 2 or 3 degrees north or south won't make that much difference, but just in that general range. So I think I'll put that off to the side right now. We can get this out of the way and just set it here on the counter. So I better get this cake going if we're going to get it into the oven. So I need 1/2 cup of cake flour.
Plain, unbleached cake flour.
That's right.
Yeah.
And I'm going to sift that, actually. And the reason I do that is to aerate the flour, and then it'll incorporate, it'll absorb the liquids a little bit better. And, of course, sifting is good if you have additional ingredients in there. If we had a little cinnamon, which would give some additional flavor. And the reason we're doing it on parchment paper is when a little later on when we add it, it makes it a little easier. You can do it on wax paper also.
Yeah.
Now, I've got 10 egg yolks in the bowl, and I'm going to put 1/2 cup of sugar in there.
Now, do you use large eggs? Or?
Yes. Okay, so we're going to put it on high for 2 minutes. So So what I'm doing here is dissolving the sugar, that half a cup of sugar, and eventually we want these egg yolks to be light and lemon in color. And
make the ribbon.
That's right, to make the ribbon. Yes. And we'll do that by putting them on for another 2 minutes. So here we go, okay. On high. Okay, this is looking great here. And we can see that the sugar is totally dissolved. Otherwise, we'd see little grains. So the sugar's dissolved, and it's nice and light and lemon in color. And I think it's.
But no, it's interesting, though. You use the paddle rather than the whisk.
That's right, because we'd create too much volume. Additionally, the next thing I'll be doing, and right now I'm going to put this on low speed, because if I do too much talking, which I do sometimes, the eggs would get lumpy if they stayed there for several minutes without some agitation. Mm-hmm. So we're going to put it on low. And now for that volume that you were talking about, we're going to whisk up some egg whites. So I have 6 egg whites and 1/4 cup of sugar. I'm going to hold off a little bit on the sugar and get some volume going here and whisk until soft peaks form. And you've got a great little tool here, an electric whisk. We can do it by hand, certainly, but I'll use the electric whisk, and it's going to take me about 2 to 3 minutes to do that. Okay, looks like we're in good shape here.
Those are soft peaks.
Yeah, soft, nice soft peaks.
Yeah.
So now I'll add my sugar, and I can do that all at once or gradually. It really is such a small amount of sugar that we can just put it right in there. So it's 1/4 cup of granulated sugar. I'll whisk that for probably another 2 minutes, and we should be in good shape. Looks like we're there. Nice stiff peaks, and they're not dry though. And the big thing about that is that if we dry them out, then those little air bubbles that we've created won't expand in the cake, and the cake won't rise gloriously out of the pan as it should.
They're lovely and shiny.
They do. They have that glistening quality. Yeah. And that's another thing. If you overbeat them, they get sort of this dull glazed look.
Yeah.
So let me, if I can get you to hold that just for a moment.
There you are.
Shut off our mixer, and now I'm going to add the white chocolate. And if I can show you this here, how significantly different the white chocolate is in appearance to the dark chocolate. And the reason is that we've tried to create an emulsion. We've got water in there, we've got additional butter, and of course lots of cocoa butter in the white chocolate. So it doesn't look as smooth as one might think it should, but this is fine because it's going to, once it goes into the eggs, it will create an emulsion.
Okay.
Let me go ahead. I'm going to put this on low and incorporate the chocolate.
Got a little bit left in there.
Yeah, we sure do. Should we lick that off or put it in there? I think we'll,
I'll lick a bit.
So I can go ahead now, actually, and take this off. And that looks great. And use the rubber spatula. And I could probably use the rubber spatula.
More?
Sure. Let's put it in there.
Boy, that sticky stuff, isn't
it? That white chocolate, again, because of all that cocoa butter, definitely reacts
good.
A little bit differently. So we can lose the paddle here now. And next item is the sifted flour. And how handy it is like this.
You put it all in at once.
All at once, and give it a couple of quick turns. And sometimes I see people folding ingredients in, and they do it so deliberately, and you want to get in there, and you're going to get a little flour dusting outside the bowl, but it's definitely...
Because you don't want it to deflate.
No, and we don't want to play around with it too much because then we start losing volume.
Don't answer the telephone.
No. Well, okay, so I'm going to add about 1/3 of the egg whites to begin with, just to lighten up the batter a little bit. And let's see, does that look... I've already failed my math test a couple of times.
That looks good.
Look like
to me.
Okay. And we'll get that in there. So that's looking good there. And let me add the rest of the egg whites. And this really is, I think when people think about chocolate, they're automatically looking for a dark, sort of turbid looking situation.
No.
And in this case here with the white chocolate, it sort of surprises you. But the flavor is definitely there. So A few more quick turns, not too many, because we certainly don't want to deflate the...
You don't put any vanilla or anything like that?
Not in this one, no. Actually, there's a little vanilla in the white chocolate.
Oh.
So now we'll get the, if you don't mind handing me the buttered pans. I've got two pans, and they happen to be non-stick pans. And the question might be, if you're using non-stick, why go through the trouble? Mm-hmm. Well, a little more insurance. We want to make sure that when we pop these out of the pan,
why is they come right up.
Well, I didn't have a round cutter today, so I just cut it into square pieces.
So it doesn't make any difference?
No, it doesn't, no. So evenly divided.
I thought it was a purpose.
Evenly divided into the two.
Well, there's a little bit of egg quite there, but that doesn't make any difference.
No, it really doesn't. That will dissipate when it cooks, because remember, we're going into the oven now. It's a 325-degree oven, and it's going to take us about 26 to 28 minutes until that old trusty toothpick inserted in the center comes out clean. Okay, does that look about even?
Mm-hmm.
I think so, pretty close to it. So anyway, I'll get those in the oven.
I'll open it for you.
And already it's smelling good. That white chocolate has a beautiful aroma.
325 and about...
26 to 28.
26 to 28. Why do we have balloons?
Well, we're going
to be a kiddie.